represents the parents and the church as well. This scripture reading comes from 4 Deuteronomy 6, 4 to 7. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are beyond your hearts. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. We, the members of the Lincoln Baptist Church, acknowledge these parents who come today not only to dedicate their child to God, but enter into a covenant with both God and His church to raise this child in the admonition of the Lord, to teach her the great truths of God as revealed in His Word, and at the appropriate time help her to see Christ as their Savior. Charge to the parents. As you engage in this task with joy and peace, may you earnestly seek the wisdom of God. May you also give thanks to God for the love and joy she brings to your home and the gift that God has given you in your daughter. As she grows physically and spiritually, strive to spend adequate time with her, developing a moral foundation and awareness of the Lordship of Christ that will guide her for the rest of her life. Charge to the church. As the Church of Jesus Christ, we realize our responsibility to these parents and to this child to provide a place of support and encouragement. May we provide a place that she may hear the whole counsel of God and continually lift this family, these families up in prayer. May we live such lives as to inspire these little ones, that in God's time they would profess faith in Christ as her Savior and Lord. We come to that time of, again, of commitment of the parents, and bear with me for a moment. Not doing this because, well, pastor's privilege and all. I'm going to ask to hold. There's no magical powers here, okay? I just like holding kids. Usually I can attract this one because she loves my fucking blessing. Yeah, see? I'm going to put you on this side, okay? All right. We're going to read something, Mom and Dad. Nick and Carrie, we ask you to covenant with God and this church to raise Lily in the fear and admonition of the Lord, to earnestly seek her salvation through teaching her the gospel through prayer, and to set before her lives that are examples of godly living. If you are willing to enter this covenant, please respond by saying, "We will."
We will.
All right, we'll go back to one. Nope. There we go. All right, now we do the baby formerly known as Baby Georgia. Now she's just Georgia, right? Oh, yeah. Marie, something. Now, I need to say something here. Mike is not here, so I can talk about it. Mike has this thing about standing up before crowds. He doesn't. So there you go. Not that he doesn't want to participate. He just doesn't feel like he can. So we understand that. All right, so we're going to read something, Mom. I'm going to say Mike's name just because. But Mike and Jenny, we ask you to covenant with God and this church to raise Georgia in the fear and admonition of the Lord, to earnestly seek her salvation through teaching her the gospel and through prayer, and to set before her lives that are examples of godly living. If you are willing to enter this covenant, please respond by saying, "We will." This time we charge the church. We ask the church to enter in this covenant as well, to be the house of worship and instruction that God has called us to be, to take an active role in the spiritual development of Lily and Georgia, and that would support the instruction she will receive at home, and to make ourselves available as instruments that God may use to bring this child into the household of faith. If the church is willing to enter in this covenant, please respond by saying, "We will."
We will.
Let's have a word of prayer.